One of the many reasons why we love Thursday nights here on Your Money Live, it is time to look through some prestige properties that are making headlines this week. Liz Tilley from the Courier Mail joins us now to walk us through them. Liz, thank you very much for being with us.
Chris.
First of all, a very big ticket item. Former Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull has finally parted ways with his Canberra apartment. What can you tell us about it?
He has. He's cut ties completely now with Canberra, turned his back on it completely with the sale of this lakeside penthouse in Kingston. Mr. Harbourside Mansion, as he's so well known, bought this one off the plan back in 2006, actually, with his wife Lucy, for $1.8 million. It's got three bedrooms and it's over two stories, and apparently it's in one of the best waterfront locations in Canberra. It has an amazing terrace which overlooks Lake Burleigh Griffin, and I think every room in it has a view of the lake. The sale price itself is being kept under wraps, but it was expected to fetch at least $2.5 million. So it would have done okay out of it, given it was only lived in for about 4 months. That was when he moved into the lodge after the renovations there were finished, so it's hardly been lived in at all. Brand new, it's a beautiful apartment, so yeah, the new owner will be pretty happy to be living it up in the ex-Prime Minister's lifestyle there, particularly a good place for parties. I'm not sure how many he would have had there, but that outdoor kitchen on the terrace would have been nice.
Yeah, pretty handy investment there for the former PM, absolutely. Now, moving on, Liz, we've got a huge property from the property boss. Anthony Catalano, formerly chief executive at Domain, has spent $30 million on a penthouse.
That's right, yeah, this news hot off the press. $30 million. Now, that's actually a record for an apartment sale in Melbourne. $40,000 a square metre that equates to. So it smashes the previous apartment price record for the city of $25 million, and that was set back in 2015. Now, as you mentioned, it was the former boss of Domain, Anthony Catalano, who's bought this one. It's a two-storey penthouse, and yeah, it hasn't even been built yet. It's in a building that's yet to be built. He's bought it off the plan, and so it must be pretty confident it's going to be nice.
Off the plan,
it's going to sit
yeah.
on. I know. It's going to sit on top of one of the buildings in the St. Moritz project on the waterfront there, which has been developed by Tim Gurner, a pretty well-known developer.
Yeah.
It's going to have seven bedrooms, four living rooms, two pools, so it's going to be huge. But it's worth noting Mr. Catalano is a father of eight, so he's probably going to need
all that room if he's going to be using
it. But it is, it's massive. It's going to be huge. It's got a floating fireplace among some of the impressive features, and a bathtub with 180-degree views. So, yeah, amazing.
I think his last house in St Kilda wasn't too shabby either. So, wow, unbelievable.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Seven bedrooms. No, two pools,
okay.
Unbelievable.
Property. Yeah,
absolutely.
Huge.
Liz,
so,
elsewhere in Bellevue Hill, a stunning home, $16 million.
That's right, just over 16.25 million. And this one, it is a stunning home on its own, but it's going to be used as an in-between house for the tech billionaire Scott Farquhar, who co-founded Atlassian. And you'll remember back in 2017, he paid $70 million for Elaine, which is one of the Fairfax family mansions on the waterfront in Double Bay.
So yes, I remember. I would have thought that's doing a dash, really, in the property stakes, but no.
Another pristine property.
Unbelievable.
Exactly. Well, apparently they're looking at renovating it because it's quite old, and I think they're going to take some time in this house to just kind of, you know, ease into it and start, you know, looking at the plans with architects and that kind of thing, and do an amazing renovation for the $70 million one, because that's the forever home. And this one's just kind of going to get them by for a couple of years while they do that. But it's not a bad place, not a bad shack to have just for a couple of years. It's got six bedrooms, five bathrooms, and it's got this Mediterranean style. You can sort of see from the pictures. It's quite beautiful itself. It's got some lovely features inside. It's been renovated, and it's also on the harbour on a huge 1,400 square metre block of land, so not bad.
Amazing. And we've got one more big name to talk about. Pete Evans of My Kitchen Rules has put his property on the market. Liz, what can you tell us about that?
Yeah, I'm not sure if you're a fan of MKR at all, but if you are, you'll know Pete Evans pretty well, and you can soon own his home. He's selling their five-bedroom, three-bathroom house at Malabar, which he owns with his wife, and they bought it back in 2014 when it was only a knockdown, and they built this one on it. It's got two levels, a rooftop terrace, but interestingly, it's also got a dedicated ping-pong room. Apparently, the whole family a big ping pong player. So be keen on that, that's something. Also a magnesium pool and an outdoor spa. So it's pretty impressive and sort of goes along with the clean eating lifestyle, I think, very healthy living. And that one's going to auction on February 23. So I think they're looking at 2.5 to 3 mil.
Yes, a paleo kitchen, if ever there was one, Liz. I reckon it's fair to say that there's been a lot of paleo meals put together in that kitchen.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I think you're right there.
Right, we'll keep an eye on that one. Liz, Tilley, thank you very much from the Courier Mail for taking us through those.
Thank you.